Please rise for the national anthem. Please remain standing for 2 minutes in silence as we respect our fallen war heroes. Thank you.
Hi, Bowen. Welcome. Welcome to the 2017 ceremony of graduation. Good morning to the distinguished guests, guests of honor, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to extend a warm welcome to you, invited guests, parents, and students, and my peers here today. As the head of school, I want to say how proud I am of the students who are graduating today, as it takes spirit, passion, and determination to get this far. The spirit to overcome difficulties in the learning process, determination to get to grips with key concepts, turning what looks very confusing, meandering through the many policies. But for example, one of the difficulties is a subject like statistics, for example, trying to get your head around the facts and figures and the numbers. Now, when you read statistics, the language is no longer foreign to you, but is a familiar language. And finally, passion, when the times get tough, juggling parenthood with studies, managing a love life, maybe, children, and other things that are in competition for your time when trying to satisfy that deadline. Oh, that deadline, 11:59 p.m., trying to rush ahead to submit that piece of work. So dare I say, turn it in, that relationship with that very difficult piece of software. Ah, at the last minute, having struggles to upload that, 2 minutes to midnight. But amidst all of that, you have done it. So congratulations. When I introduce myself to batches now, the most common thing I talk about is a word that's really important when you leave an institution. That word is the why factor. If you're leaving here saying, I know everything, then we as a team of academics have not done our job well at all. But if my staff have inspired you for a thirst for more knowledge, they have introduced you to unanswered questions in the research that proves a drive to do a PhD and fill that gap of knowledge, then the team has done their job well. If you have enjoyed learning new ideas and you have been inspired to know more, that's great. That's a perfect position to be in. Because it's the person who asks the why that discovers new ideas, adds knowledge, innovates, creates, and moves on to bigger and better things. It is not the job of the educator to spoon-feed information so that you just simply pass an exam, but instead ignite a flame within which then can be carried forward to the next person, the group, and society as a whole. Having an education will give you a helping hand away from poverty. Worldwide, women in old age end up in poorer situations than their male counterparts. This we found out in my work when I collaborated with 10 other academics for a piece of work that we published recently, and looking at mental health, old age, and discrimination. The gap between men and women is far apart between the younger old and the older old. And what I mean by that is the younger old is classified as 65 upwards, and the older old, 95 and upwards. And there's a huge gap. And what are the reasons for this? Well, women typically are the caregivers, and so therefore don't have the time to study. Men, on the other hand, are more likely to receive an education and therefore survive better in older age. Now, this does not make sense, when women worldwide live on average 5 years longer than men. So I put it all to you, ladies and gentlemen, and distinguished guests, and the students here today. I set you this challenge. Go and inspire. Go and innovate. Go and create. Challenge the misconceptions of work and the wage discrepancies within the workforce. We have to challenge, that's our duty, we have to challenge the inequalities when they arise. And with Sri Lanka now a middle-income country, and what comes with that is a deeper responsibility to protect those that are marginalized in society. And who are they? Well, the marginalized are the people with mental illness, the aging population, the people with learned disabilities, transgendered men and women, the homeless person, and the VEDA communities.